Welcome to the Morning Touch on Darwin Campbell. The Morning Touch, brought to you by Samaritan Touch Homeless Services, where we meet the homeless right where they are. You know, it's been a fast 24 hours from Election Day to the day after, election hangover, as it were, where there are winners and there are losers. But whether you win or whether you lose, isn't the most important thing. The most important thing is an examination of one's own direction. I know there are those whose eyes are filled with tears, and there are those whose hearts are filled with joy. There are winners, and then there are those who don't win. I want to share with you, with God's own word, the true new way forward. Now, in these campaigns, we've heard a great deal about new ways forward. Well, when I look at the term new way forward, I want us to look at it from a not from a political perspective, but from a biblical perspective. At the Morning Touch, we look at everything from a biblical perspective. God's own word speaking, God's own heart talking and proclaiming. What is this new way forward? In Isaiah chapter 2, verses 3 through 5, we get insight into God's definition of what it means, the new way forward. What should be our focus? What should be our direction? What should be our purpose? As we live this life, as we walk through day in and day out, the time that God gives us, what should be our focus? Isaiah gives us insight about the mountain of the Lord, where he called upon the children of God to come to the mountain of the Lord, where he encourage them to come to the mountain of the Lord. Because you see, at the mountain of the Lord, that's where you find the new way forward. At the mountain of the Lord, that's where you find the truth. Truth is not found in being emotional. Truth is not found by being earthbound in your thinking and your mindset. The child of God, one who truly develops a relationship with God, is not earthbound in thinking and earthbound in mind. The one who truly accepts Jesus Christ and the one who truly believes that God's word is inspired, 2 Timothy 3:16 and 17, you will look for that new way forward, because the new way forward leads you to the mountain of the Lord, and the mountain of the Lord leads you to a relationship, an eternal relationship with him. Listen to what Isaiah says. Many people will come and say, come, let us go to the mountain of the Lord, to the temple of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his ways so that we may walk in his paths. The law will go out from Zion and the word from Jerusalem. He will judge between the nations, will settle disputes for many people. They will beat the swords into plowshares, their spears into pruning hooks. Nations will not take up sword against nation, nor will they train for war anymore. Come, descendants of Jacob, let us walk in the light of the Lord. The new way forward is not set by a political party. The new way forward is not set by the winner of this election. The new way forward is forged when we, as a people, develop a relationship with God. When we come to the mountain and we humble ourselves before God and we ask for his mercy, we ask for his forgiveness, and we walk in the same mind and in the same judgment. The new way forward is a way that develops our hearts towards learning how to love one another, learning how to communicate with one another. Learn how to live with one another. Learn how to share with one another. Not create a war of words. Not create walls and barriers. Not tossing out accusations against one another. The new way forward, God's new way forward, involves coming to the mountain and developing a healthy respect for the word of God. Amen. A new way forward starts when people decide to do what Jesus said in Matthew 6:33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto you. You see, God is not dead. God is alive. And it behooves each and every one of us to learn about this God. Stop being earthbound. Stop being earth-minded. Stop being earth-focused. And think about a relationship with God. Think about a connection with the one true God. Come to the mountain to find your new way forward. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and you'll see what God can do. When I look at Proverbs 14:34, what does that mean for a nation? That means blessed is that nation who puts God first. Blessed is that nation whose God is the Lord. Righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. Righteousness lifts us up. Sin brings us down. Let me say that again. Righteousness lifts a nation up, but sin brings us all down. And my friends, when we learn that valuable lesson, then we will select the box that says a new way forward. A new way forward, not from an earthly perspective, not from political policies, but a new way forward that means that each and every one of us is taking a serious stance towards righteousness, a serious stance towards biblical integrity, a serious stance towards godliness. A new way forward means that you will establish a relationship first, by repenting of your sins and asking God for forgiveness, and then seeking out those of like mind who are walking this new way forward. The Bible says in Matthew 7:13-14, straight is the gate and narrow is the way, and few there'll be that will find it. In spite of our appeal to call upon every American to seek out this new way forward, to come to the mountain of the Lord, to allow God to light up your life and your heart with truth and a strong relationship, the Bible says, few there'll be that will find it, because broad is the gate, broad is the way, and wide is the gate, and many go in thereat. There are those because of their selfishness. There are those because of their desire to follow others. There are those because of their allegiances to parties that will not check the box, that will not seek out God, that will refuse to yield their will, that will not be humble. My friends, that is the broad way. That is the wide gate. But our appeal on the Morning Touch is for you to find the new way forward. A new way that leads to the mountain of the Lord. A new way that allows the Lord to teach us his ways. A new way, Isaiah said, that allows us to walk in his paths. A new way, as Isaiah said, that will teach us how to relate to one another without friction and without hate. A new way forward is the love of Jesus. And my friends, when I look at verse 5 says it all, the appeal. Come, let us walk in the light of the Lord. The only way to walk in the light of the Lord is you must come to the mountain of the Lord. You must humble yourself. You must allow the Lord to lift you up when you humble yourself. James 4:10. A new way forward. I encourage you and I appeal to you as we wind this down. Let us seek to walk in the light of the Lord. Doesn't matter who's in the White House. Doesn't matter who's in the State House. Doesn't matter who controls Congress. What's important is that you develop a relationship, a new way forward, by coming to the mountain of the Lord and standing there and asking God for yourself. Lord, lift me up. Lord, strengthen me. Lord, forgive me. I repent of my sins. I want this new way forward. And I hope, trust, and pray that that's your desire. Titus 2 and 12. We hope that with your new way forward, that you will choose to walk united in the faith and live soberly and righteously and godly in this present world. There is a new way forward, but you've got to come.